Despite being the most used Excel formula, VLOOKUP has a huge limitation. It can't return results based on multiple criteria. For instance, finding iPhone sales, but only in New York. Or can it? Today, I'm going to show you two ways to make it happen. And if you stick around till the end, I'll also teach you a function that'll make you ditch VLOOKUP for good. So, when we've got a table like this with sales split by product and city, finding iPhone sales in New York might seem like an impossible task with just one formula. Why? Because a standard VLOOKUP only takes one criterion. In other words, it can search by one column at a time. It can return the iPhone sales or New York sales, but not the combo. The first way to fix this problem is using a helper column. Let me explain. We'll add a new column called helper. In this column, we'll create a unique identifier by concatenating the city name with the product name. To do this, just open a new formula, select the city name, add an ampersand, then a dash in quotes, another ampersand, and finally the product name. This gives us a unique value that we can use as a search term in a slightly tweaked regular VLOOKUP. Bet you didn't know, but the VLOOKUP search value can be made up of concatenated text values. So, we'll do the same concatenation we did in the helper column as the search value. Pick the city name, add an ampersand, a dash in quotes, another ampersand, and then the product. Now, for the search range, we only need the helper column and the sales now, right? Everything else is repeated data. Next, the budget is in column number 2 of our range, and we're looking for an exact match. And there you have it. The correct number pops up. But wait, there's a quicker method that doesn't need a helper column. In fact, it's the function I mentioned that'll replace VLOOKUP for good. But before we dive into that, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Every week, I'm giving away a complete Excel course worth $297 to 10 lucky subscribers. Now, the VLOOKUP killer. The XLOOKUP function. If you're not familiar, think of it as VLOOKUP on steroids. It's just as powerful but without any of the limitations. Kick off an XLOOKUP formula, and you'll see it asks for 5 things. Only 3 are must-haves, the rest are optional for this case. First up, the search value. Like in our VLOOKUP example, we'll concatenate the city and product. But here's the first difference from XLOOKUP. You don't need a dash or anything. Just link them with an ampersand. This tells XLOOKUP exactly what combo we needed to search for. Next, indicate the search ranges. Since we have 2 concatenated search values, it makes sense that we need 2 concatenated search ranges, right? So, select your city range, add an ampersand, and then the product range. Essentially, we're instructing XLOOKUP to find this city value in the city range and this product value in the product range, and when you find the row where both match, return the value I specify. This brings us to the last request, the return array, which is the column with the data you want back, in this case, the sales. Another difference from VLOOKUP. Instead of specifying the column number, just select the range. Close your function, and there you have it. Way easier, don't you think?